If you can just ignore the whippersnipper behind me, this is a piece of comb that I, some cross comb that I pulled out one of my frames, but the bees that were working the comb are still on it, and they're vibrating. I don't know if you can see it, but I can feel the vibrations of these bees just beating their wings through the comb. They sort of beat their wings. There you go. That one right there just did it. And this is how the bees, this is one of the ways the bees communicate with each other. They communicate through vibrations through the comb itself. And you get that in natural comb. And the plastic foundation that we use in a lot of our frames can interfere with that communication. So in a way, it's better not to use plastic foundation, because if you ever pick up a piece of comb like this full of bees, let me just see if I can see if these guys are doing it here. And you can feel the vibrations, just like Marky Mark. Yeah, that you can just pick up a piece of comb with a bunch of bees on it and just feel it, and you feel the vibrations of the wings beating, and that's how they're talking, right? If you're a bee, if I can feel it, then you know a little tiny bee can feel it on the other end of the comb when they're vibrating. And when the bees come in for after discovering some exciting nectar source, some big, you know, nectar source that they're all elated about, they get on that comb and they start doing their little dance, but they beat their wings like crazy, and that vibration goes through the comb, and all the other bees notice the vibrations and go, hey, what's going on? And they come over and they check it out, and it's a part of how they communicate. So you'll get that on the comb, but you're not going to get the same vibrations on a piece of plastic, I don't think. Anyway, could be wrong.